are without doubt the worst pirate I've ever heard of.
But you have heard of me.
Welcome to Watch Mojo, and today we're counting down our picks for the best background bloopers left in movies. These aren't continuity errors, but rather little oopsies not part of the main focus of the scene.
The prisoner wishes to say a word.
Number 10, Not Really Dead, The Patriot.
And how did King George reward me? He cuts off my other leg with his taxes.
When it comes to Mel Gibson movies where someone dies and comes back to life, you'd probably think we were talking about The Passion of the Christ. However, in this case, we're discussing the extended cut of the Gibson-led war epic, The Patriot.
Take this one to Camden. Here's a spy. Hang him, put his body on display.
But unlike the former, the guy in The Patriot was supposed to stay dead, at least until the scene faded completely to black. Was it the actor's fault for moving too early, or the editor's fault for not fading to black quicker? We're not sure. All we know is that the dead guy lifts his head while we can still see him.
Why should I trust a man who betrays neighbors?
Well, those neighbors of mine who stand against England deserve to die a traitor's death, hmm?
Number 9. Ladder to the Head. Christmas with the Kranks.
We're taking a break. We're not gonna do Christmas this year.
Being a real fireman is a dangerous job, but it turns out being a pretend fireman isn't always smooth sailing either. As one extra found out on the set of the 2004 holiday comedy, Christmas with the Kranks. Why Tim Allen's character is hanging upside down in the scene doesn't matter. What matters is what happens when the firemen get there to save him. Watch as one of the guys takes the ladder off the truck and walks towards the action. Now watch the other firefighter standing there minding his own business. It's like we're in a Three Stooges movie within another Three Stooges movie. Stoogeception.
Got him?
Huh?
Luther, you okay?
Number 8. Camera Guy. Bad Boys.
Hopefully you will realize that what you did was wrong. Hopefully you will never do anything like that again.
Not to be confused with the Will Smith and Martin Lawrence movie, 1983's Bad Boys starring Sean Penn is set in a juvenile detention center. And while it's normal for detention centers to have cameras watching the inmates, we're pretty sure none of them have, or have, actual camera guys roaming around.
All right, this is Supervisor Wagner. Sir will also do. O'Brien, Terrell. Gentlemen, enjoy your rehabilitation.
But maybe the detention center in Bad Boys was a new kind of center that used actual cinematographers to capture the goings-on. Or maybe no one noticed the camera guy in the shot during this fight scene. Maybe you've never noticed him either, but you sure will from now on.
All right. You'll serve the remainder of your time in this program in solitary confinement, starting now.
Number 7. I Shouldn't Be Here, Terminator 2, Judgment Day.
Stay here. I'll be back.
You'd be forgiven if you never noticed this one, given the intensity of the moment as Arnold Schwarzenegger's Terminator walks towards a firing line of police officers. But after the cops tell Schwarzenegger to get down, and just before they start shooting, take a look through the windows behind them.
Okay, drop him!
What you'll see is some random guy who just walks right into the scene outside the building. A lost extra? A wayward crew member? A Schwarzenegger fanboy? Who knows? But regardless, we feel pretty confident saying that they weren't supposed to be there.
Hasta la vista, baby.
Number 6. Just Fall Down. The Dark Knight Rises.
No one cared who I was till I put on the mask.
There's a scene in The Dark Knight Rises that finds Batman and Catwoman on a rooftop taking on a bunch of Bane's henchmen. In the end, they're the only ones left standing after knocking out the barrage of bad guys.
I'm not bluffing!
They know! They just don't care.
Well, actually, they didn't really knock them all out. Look closely at the background here. As Batman is fighting off a couple of foot soldiers, a third approaches the Caped Crusader from screen left. But before Batman is even able to knock him out, the guy stops, stumbles backwards, and falls to the ground. We get it. We wouldn't want to fight Batman either.
gotta be kidding me.
No guns, no killing.
Where's the fun in that?
Number 5. Cowboys and Pirates. Pirates of the Caribbean, The Curse of the Black Pearl.
Thought you were supposed to keep to the code. We figured they were more actual guidelines.
As a kid, did you ever play Cowboys and Pirates? No, we didn't either. But that must have been what they were playing on the set of the first Pirates of the Caribbean movie just before shooting this scene.
Captain Sparrow. The Black Pearl is yours.
Either that, or some random crew member wearing modern clothes and a cowboy hat was standing in the background on the ship and got caught in the shot. As much as we'd like to imagine it was the former, the more likely answer is the latter. Either way, it's a mistake that no one noticed before it was too late.
Now, bring me that horizon.
Number 4. Spidey Web Shooting. Cherry. In case you didn't know, actor Tom Holland played Spider-Man in multiple movies between 2017 and the release of Cherry in February of 2021.
There's Captain America, Iron Man, Black Widow. Whoa, who's that new guy? Oh, that's me. I gotta go.
Hey, everyone.
With that in mind, we can now check out the scene from Cherry, which sees a military-clad Holland lying on the ground as other army personnel walk by, ignoring him completely.
I started to get this weird feeling like it was all just make-believe. That we were just pretending to be soldiers.
Well, almost all of them walk by and ignore him. You might notice three of the guys moving past him who, not only do they not ignore him, they move past while doing the Spidey shooting out webs motion at him. We guess with great power comes great idiocy as well.
Yeah, but are you okay?
I'm good now.
Number 3. The Car. Braveheart.
William Wallace.
Gotta be. No tall enough.
Just to be clear, the film Braveheart takes place between 1280 and 1314. The automobile was invented in the 1800s. Why is this important? Well, remember the famous hold scene in Braveheart? You know, the one where William Wallace has his men hold until the very last second before switching their swords for long spikes and impaling the attacking forces?
That they may take our lives, but they'll never take our freedom!
Great scene, right? Yes, it is. But if you look in the lower left-hand corner of the screen as the opposing army attacks, just a few moments before Wallace gives the now command, yep, that's a car. There was also a car in Middle Earth in the theatrical version of The Fellowship of the Ring, although it was removed for the DVD version.
If I take one more step, it'll be the farthest away from home I've ever been.
Come on, Sam.
Number 2. Horse Kick. The Last Samurai.
You ride against us, and you are the same as they are.
I'll look for you on the field.
It's something you'd expect to see on an episode of America's Funniest Home Videos, not a big budget period drama. But alas, check out the 2003 film The Last Samurai, and you'll see a horse kick a guy in the naughty bits. No, it isn't Tom Cruise. And even if it was, we assume that's one stunt he wouldn't do himself. No, instead it happened by accident to a poor extra who just happened to be in the wrong place at the wrong time. The place being beside a horse. The time being when the horse kicked out his hind leg.
Captain. Godspeed.
Mr. Graham.
Before we continue, be sure to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified about our latest videos. You have the option to be notified for occasional videos or all of them. If you're on your phone, make sure you go into your settings and switch on notifications. Number 1. Psychic Kid, North by Northwest.
By the way, I want to compliment you on your colorful exit from the auction gallery.
Thank you.
When Eva Marie Saint pulls a gun on Cary Grant at the Mount Rushmore Visitor Center in 1959's North by Northwest, no one knows if she's actually going to pull the trigger. Wait, that's not true. Do you see that little boy with the blue shirt sitting at the table in the background? Watch what he does the second Eva Marie Saint pulls the gun from her purse.
Just get back.
You little fool.
You just stay away from me.
Stop. While everyone else looks scared, the kid sticks his fingers in his ears in anticipation of the loud bang that is to come. Alfred Hitchcock was known for plot twist, but the kid apparently saw this one coming.
Hello.
Hello.
Are you all right?
Yes, I think so.
Have you ever noticed any of these background bloopers before we mentioned them? Let us know in the comments.
No.
Did you enjoy this video? Check out these other clips from WatchMojo, and be sure to subscribe and ring the bell to be notified about our latest videos.